and welcome to my channel. I am your SPARX stenographer. Today I am going to deliver you a shortened dictation from Kailash Chandra magazine volume 22 and the transcription number 475. And guys, if you like my video, then subscribe my channel and also join me on WhatsApp. And you have any query, you can ask me on comment box. So guys, ready for the dictation? 10 seconds, 5 seconds. Start. Sir, while speaking yesterday, I referred to the problem created for the Export Promotion Council by the quality of goods supplied which lacked both imagination and integrity. Therefore, not only have standards to be laid down, but some help has also to be given by way of backing properly to all those people who would also like to ask the Honorable Minister to clarify as to how he is going to lay down the standard for the goods. Will the contract between the buyer and the seller be concluded first and then the quality or standard will be decided? The question of price has to be settled, and we also know that the price varies according to the country that buys the article. I think the House rightly laid emphasis on the desirability of fixing some standard for goods for the home market and also for our imports. The standard for imports, I am told, and are governed by other international imports rules. Those also must be varying according to the country of import. In any case, unless there are some standards laid down for the case of goods in the home market, there will be difficulty. There are people who are used to selling things different from what they had advertised. The things advertised is something other than what is actually sold. So unless our traders are trained to respect integrity and some business morals, it is not possible for them suddenly to rise to the occasion and out of patriotic motives sells goods of the particular specified standard. I would also like to make a suggestion to the Honorable Minister and say that it is not enough to lay down the rules for the export quality control and inspection. It is very necessary now to advertise in the foreign countries that we have taken care of this aspect because of the bad name that we have acquired in the past on account of the business ways of some of the exporters. We have acquired a very bad name in some of the countries, and in order to counteract that, we have to undertaken wide publicity in foreign countries to undo what has been done so far. There is one more question which I would like to ask the Honorable Minister so that he may clarify the doubt that may be in the mind of some honorable members. It is stated that the funds for the Export Promotion Council would be partially from the government and partially from the funds paid by the way of donation. I want to know whether its donors, if they are business people, would not be in a position to take advantage of the position and misuse this Export Promotion Council. Instead, I would suggest that heavy fees may be prescribed for the inspection of the goods, and if necessary, all the money that is required should come from the government and no money should be accepted by way of donation. I would also like to the government to see that the punishment is not so much in the form of the fine, because it is well known that where money is good freely, either through black marketing, or by taking advantage of certain trade conditions. Fine is no consideration at all. 10 or even 100 times the fine can be made good by the people who indulge in these malpractices. Therefore, it is not only enough to prescribe punishment for the purpose who are found guilty under this act, but it is also necessary that we prescribe heavy punishment for the inspectors so as to leave no room for suspicion in the minds of the people. I would now like to refer to the question of co-option. I do not know why it is has not occurred to the members in the opposition and those who doubted the need for co-option that the variety of goods itself will not make it possible for the council to have members on the council who would be conversant with the qualities of all types of goods. This council is really something or par with the UPSC in many opinion. And for every particular specialized item, it would be necessary for the council to co-option one or two experts become belonging to the particular trade. I would, if I may, like to clarify one point in regard to the statement that fell from one of the members yesterday with regard to the deal we had to Poland and Russia over shoes. The deal was found defective because the shoes were different according to the changing of fashions. This particular item has come in the report of the Public Accounts Committee. The deal was found defective because the foreigners who are used to machine-made goods expected goods of exactly the same standard as of machine-made goods. Our Indian shoes were made by hand and all of them did not answer the same specifications. These shoes were not meant for fashionable ladies or for other, but they were really meant for the army. Stop.